If you're looking for the perfect hairstyle for your face shape, which I know a lot of people have been asking for, we're actually in the process of developing an algorithm that can do such a thing. Facial identification systems can be used to recommend the most complementary styles based on a face shape using a machine learning classifier. Machine learning systems can use basic information from your facial morphology to predict objectively what features will best suit your face. The QOVES team in the backend has done many applications of AI and beauty, and we're going to be releasing it soon on our new website, QOVES Laboratory. For now, let's take a look at how such an algorithm would work by following the research literature. This can be done by evaluating many objective things like ocular morphology, which is the size and shape of your eyes, determined through your skull composition, eye color, and eyelid shape. It can also be done through your jaw shape, looking at how it complements your teeth and cheekbones. Most easily, however, machine learning systems can use your overall face shape, defined by a facial recognition classifier, to recommend certain features that would best suit your face. Today, we're going to look closer at how face shape classifiers can be used to predict the perfect hairstyle. A 2018 paper by Pasupa et al. Outlines a support vector machine that has been in construction, which recommends a chosen hairstyle for a user based on scientific aesthetic evidence. From there, it allows the user to wear a certain hairstyle and see how they look. The basis of this technology comes down to being able to divide face shape into five main categories. The main categories are 1. An oblong shape, defined by a long, thin face with equal width for your cheeks, forehead, and jawline. An oblong face shape is also defined by a chin with a very slight curve. Sarah Jessica Parker and Alexa Chung are two well-known attractive individuals with this face shape. Looking at Alexa here, you can see that the distances between the two sides of her forehead, the two sides of her cheekbones, and the two sides of her jaw are a very similar length, along with the characteristic slight curve in her chin. The second main face shape category is the round shape, characterized by a very circular head, in which the cheekbones are the widest part of the face. On top of that, the chin of a round face is significantly curved, with the sides of your face curving outwards instead of being straight like they are in an oblong shape. Jennifer Lawrence is one lady with a circular shaped face, and as you can see here, the sides of her face extend outwards as we move from the forehead to the cheekbones, and then back inwards as we move from the cheekbones to the chin, showing that her cheekbones are indeed the widest part of her face. The next shape is the humble oval shape. An oval-shaped face is characterized by a tall forehead, where the cheekbones are the widest part of the face, again, and an overall face that is longer than it is wide. We would call this a leptoprosopic face, meaning that it is tall and narrow, and as we covered in our East Asian beauty standards, this is the ideal preferred for both men and women in that region. Oval-shaped faces, whilst also having the cheekbones as the widest part of the face, are both longer than round faces and have a smaller difference in length between the forehead and the cheekbones. If we look at Blake Lively's face, in this example, we can see that it is much longer than it is wide, and the cheekbones, once again, are the widest part of the face. The fourth of the five main face shapes is the square-shaped face. This shape, unlike the oval shape, has a very masculine characteristic as it requires a very wide jaw. Now, on our video on sexual dimorphism, we covered that wide jaws are somewhat influenced by testosterone, and so this is, again, a masculinizing feature. The square, unlike the oval, has the same overall height, that is from the forehead to the chin, as it does width. In case you skipped preschool, that's a square. As well as this, the sides of the face are very straight, with reduced malar projection, and to emphasize that it's a masculine feature, this is partly because cheekbone projection is influenced by estrogen, and so men, generally having less estrogen, produce straighter facial contours, just like the sides of a square. It is typical for those with square-shaped faces to have sharp and angular features, like a sharp jawline. In this picture, Cameron Diaz is accentuating the traits of her face, shown through the constant width all along it, and again, this is seen by these horizontal lines across the face. A similar width and height of her overall face, and through the sharp features like her jawline. The final of the five face shapes is the heart-shaped face. Now, research has shown that there is a bias towards heart-shaped and diamond shapes because it's a healthy mix of feminine features, and so for women, it would be the ideal, and for men who want to look more pretty and, I suppose, handsome, quote-unquote, rather than rugged and masculine, it would also work very well. In a heart-shaped face, the forehead is the widest part of the face and your chin is particularly pointed. It's also typical for a heart shape to have a widow's peak, a distinct peak of the hairline at the center of the forehead. To illustrate the point, you can look at Timothée Chalamet, who has a heart-shaped face, but it also makes him look very feminine, but quite handsome. We have actually done a full breakdown of his aesthetic, so you can check that out after. We can't obviously simplify the distinct and unique facial diversity into five main facial categories. In fact, it's not even the full list of possible face shapes out there, and further shapes like the diamond shape, with a narrow hairline, high cheekbones, and a pointed chin, similar to the heart face, as well as the triangular face shape, which has a wide forehead, and that tapers down to a much narrower jawline. It's quite similar to the heart shape, but the difference is at the cheekbones. Now that you know the description of the face shapes, there is considerable scientific evidence to suggest that each unique face shape has a set of hairstyles which best complements them. Some basic geometric rules defined through aesthetic guidelines make for objective reasoning as to which hairstyle works for which shape. The objectively and geometrical application allows machine learning systems to A. identify quickly which face shape people have and take into consideration the width and the height of that shape, as well as the width of the forehead, cheekbones, jawline, and shape of the chin. B. recommend the most suitable hairstyle based on this information presented in A. To develop this technology, the researchers stated that they coded a face shape recognition classifier using the characteristics for each shape measured above and trained the system using 1,000 relevant faces, simply through a Google image search. To train the system, the researchers compared the manual labeling of face shapes from volunteers and compared them to the facial shape recognition system to ensure consistency. After this point, a landmark localization technique called the active appearance model looks at the vital points of the face and skin pigmentation, separating the hair and forehead, allowing them to calculate the geometric features to represent face shape. This active appearance technology, alongside mathematical ratios of the height of the face to the width, the distance between the jaws, the distance between the chin and the bottom of the mouth, the angle between the straight line from the boundary of the face at a considered point to the chin point, have allowed them to scientifically classify which hairstyles are the best based on hard geometric evidence. If you're enjoying the content, remember to like and subscribe to QOVES Studio. One of the issues in developing AI technology is the role of ethnic bias due to a lack of training data. This paper uses only East Asian faces for training and to show that it is actually possible, but our face shape classifier, which is currently in development, and virtually all of our AI tools are trained using the Fairface dataset, which has equal weightings of 7 racial groups and is the best that machine learning currently has. We're going to make a full video on racial bias in AI beauty because it's a very relevant topic to our work, but I wanted to clear things up and acknowledge the current limitations that we have in the machine learning field in this video as well. Alright, so let's go back to Pasupas' paper to see how they've built their hair classification model. They use what's known as a support vector machine, which recommends hairstyles based on 4 attributes, the length being either pixie, which is where the short hair sits above the head, short, which is around the ear to neck length, mid, and then long. The next attribute that the system recommends based on is the style, which can be either straight, wavy, or a mix of the two. The third is the fringe, where the algorithm decides whether you should or shouldn't have a fringe, a straight fringe that goes across the lining of the eyes, or a side-swept fringe which goes on the side of the forehead. The last attribute is whether your hair should be layered or not, which is a hairstyle that gives the illusion of length and volume. After these recommendations are given, the technology can then map the hairstyle onto the face using these specific reference points that we mentioned earlier, related to a forehead, chin, and cheekbone shape. For a round-shaped face, the technology suggests a medium-length hairstyle, about shoulder width with a side-swept fringe. Both curled and straight hair are recommended, however the hairstyles should be used to create extra height in the face, and as such, it shouldn't be tucked behind the ears, as this will accentuate the roundness of the face, contrary to the idea of adding height. If we look back to our example of Jennifer Lawrence, a typical example of a round face, she uses medium length hair, a side-swept fringe on one side, and a slightly curved style, and she does actually tuck her hair behind her ears, but only on one side. Shown is a summary of the recommendations that this tool is going to generally give you. Now, you have to remember that these researchers are not facial aestheticians, and so their advice is limited by language, preciseness, and accuracy, but their methodology in machine learning is most definitely robust. For the QOVES model, we intend to include more races, which is a given, and with that comes greater inclusivity for Black and Arabian hairstyles, which are often neglected in AI training datasets. If you are a hairstylist or have some experience with recommending hairstyles, we'd like to hear from you at jobs@qoves.com so that the advice our tool gives is as in-depth and accurate as possible. It's a community effort. Let's do another example. For the square-shaped face, a hairstyle will be most attractive if it softens the hard and sharp structures of the face opposite to what is recommended with the round shape. However, much like the round shape, the hairstyle should be used to try to add height to the face. The researchers recommend achieving this with a side-swept fringe, which softens the hard and sharp corners of the face, and it is also recommended that the hairstyle have medium to long length hair. A strong and straight fringe isn't recommended, as this will accentuate the sharp elements of the face. Those with oval-shaped faces are actually quite lucky. This shape is linked to a wide variety of hairstyles that can be considered attractive. Unlike the round and square shapes, it's advised to not try to add extra height to the face, as the oval shape is already quite long and leptoprosopic. For the oblong or rectangular shaped face, curly hair is recommended, as is short hair. These features will reduce the height of the face and create a fuller, more harmonious face shape. Finally, for the heart shape, a side-swept fringe is recommended to ensure that it has equal length down the length of its face. Long and layered hair is also recommended, with the option to be either curly or straight. Personally speaking, I don't exactly agree with all of these recommendations because, like I said, they're not aestheticians, they don't consider more aspects of the face. The researcher's advice is kind of written like a BuzzFeed article, and the proposed hairstyles are quite female-centric. I mean, I don't expect men to be getting side-swept fringes anytime soon. These are things that we're going to be working on in our version to give much more rigorous advice for both men and women, with different versions for each. And we need your help in getting user data on what you guys think looks the best, depending on the face shape. I recommend that you follow us on Instagram and Twitter. I mean, this isn't a shameless plug. We actually need your advice to create something good. So let's close this video out. Overall, the face shape of anyone can be objectively defined by looking at the skull morphology, with specific reference to the chin, cheekbones, and forehead, and special consideration of their relationships to each other. From these geometric factors, we can then recommend hairstyles that focus on the length, the style, the fringe, and the layers, such that these features are actually complemented rather than going against each other. Again, as mentioned, there are limitations in this paper, and I'm not saying that it's perfect advice, take it with a grain of salt. But to reiterate, if you want to help us on this project of building a tool that can accurately recommend hairstyles based on facial features, then we need your help, especially with Black and Arabian thick and curly hair, because we're not experts on those fields. So I urge you to reach out to us and give us some advice. If you'd like to get your face assessed by either AI or with our team of doctors and dentists, then you can order a QOVES aesthetics report over at the website. You'll get 7,000 words of technical feedback tailored to your face shape and a full analysis of your features, their proportions, their relations, their anthropological values, the whole lot. Everything we do on the channel is going back into this report.